In this section, we will look at the most commonly used modern fuel oil system. This system will be illustrated systematically, from bunkers up to the main engine. This heavy fuel oil transfer system includes four bunker tanks, one spill oil tank, a transfer pump, and the necessary piping. The transfer pump can suck oil from any of the bunker tanks or the spill oil tank and discharge it into the settling tanks or back to the bunker tanks. The bunker tanks are heated by steam. The heat transfer is proportional to the steam pressure, which is set by manually controlled throttle valves. If the heating is turned off, the bunker tank temperature will slowly cool down towards ambient temperature. The flow resistance in the heavy fuel oil lines is dependent on temperature. The spill oil tank input comes from the overflow of heavy fuel oil settling tank number 1, heavy fuel oil settling tank number 2, heavy fuel oil service tank, diesel oil service tank. It also comes from the drain flow of mixer tank, heavy fuel oil service tank, diesel oil service tank, main engine leak oil system, main engine lube oil system. A heavy fuel oil transfer pump transports the fuel oil from the bunker tanks or the spill oil tank to one of two settling tanks. The transfer pump should be started locally at the low settling tank level or the high spill oil tank level. By means of a flexible piping system, the heavy fuel oil separators can suck oil from one or both settling tanks, separate it, and discharge it back to either of the settling tanks or to the heavy fuel oil service tank. The heating of the settling tanks is managed by manual or automatic thermostatic control. If the temperature of the oil in the settling tank cools below a certain limit, it will be difficult for the separator's feed pump to transport the oil. The tank is shaped so that the water in the oil from the bunker tank will gradually sink towards the tank bottom by force of gravity. If the water that has been collected is not discharged on a regular basis, heavy fuel oil separator problems will develop, such as a broken water seal. The drain valves can be opened by hand in the engine room. If the plant is shut down without any heating, the oil in the venting tank will cool down due to loss of heat in the surroundings. Depending upon temperature and possible dilution of diesel oil, the oil viscosity in the venting tank is calculated. If the viscosity at booster pump inlet is high, the fuel oil pump discharge pressure will decrease. The flow resistance in fuel oil heaters and filters depends upon the viscosity. The fuel oil pipeline and the venting tank can be heated by steam tracing. The steam has to be turned on or off manually. If the oil in the fuel oil pipe gets too cold, the pressure drop across the fuel oil filter and fuel oil heater increases greatly. The oil pressure from the booster pumps will drop correspondingly. In this example, fuel oil from the heavy fuel oil service tank and the diesel oil service tank are mixed in an oil mixing valve. Two fuel oil supply pumps with 4 bar outlet pressure transport the fuel oil to the venting tank. The two booster fuel oil pumps connected to the venting tank and the heaters operate at 8 bar outlet pressure. Two fuel oil filters in unison permit repair and cleaning of one of them during normal operations. The flow from the pressure control valve at the main engine returns fuel oil to the venting tank. The fuel flow to the main engine and diesel generators is measured by a flow meter mounted in the common inlet pipe to the venting tank. The fuel oil meter can be bypassed to permit repair. The oil delivery from the booster pumps is reduced if the suction pressure drops below a certain limit. Because of the steam tracing facility, the main engine can be stopped and restarted on heavy fuel oil. The normal procedure, however, is to change to diesel oil a short time before shutting down the engine. This has a cleaning effect by filling the piping system with diesel oil and ensures a safe startup at a later time. The change from heavy fuel oil to diesel oil, or vice versa, should be performed gradually. If the rate of temperature reduction during transfer from heavy fuel oil to diesel oil is too high, some of the high-pressure injection plungers might stick due to plunger liner contraction or reduced lubrication. The heavy fuel oil tank and the venting tank can be drained to the spill oil tank. If a water leakage in the service tank heater has occurred, it will be necessary to empty the heavy fuel oil tank and to drain water from the venting tank. If the fuel oil temperature after the fuel oil heaters rises higher than the fuel's boiling temperature, the result is gassing of the oil. Oil viscosity is assumed to be a gassing indicator. As this falls under approximately 2 centistokes, gassing of the fuel oil gradually starts, leading to the running of the main engine becomes unstable. The signal from the viscosity meter becomes very noisy. Normally, heavy fuel oil gassing develops above 135 degrees Celsius, and for diesel oil, it develops above 80 degrees Celsius.